Growing Light marked the conclusion of our newfound adventure. And before we set off to meet our guests from the new world, let's recap the closing events on the 13th. If you want to get caught up to this point, I have recap videos of all Endwalker patches on my channel. I'll leave the links in the description. This is the main story catch-up of patch 6.5, Growing Light. We begin in Rad Zatan, with everyone gathering to share information on how things are progressing. Since we returned to the source, the power of Zero must have been bleeding through the Void Gate, and even though the brands that once held Zodiark are in place, even they are being taxed and will not hold forever. Yrstola has come up with a way that we can fight Zeromus, with the Blade of Light to pierce the Shield of Darkness. The process involves setting up Aetheric Collectors on the first, which will channel light-aspected aether into the Crystal Tower. Then, we set up Aetheric Receivers on the 13th, and when everything is ready to go, the Crystal Tower will channel the aether it's collected into the Rift, and the Receivers will draw it forth to the 13th. Where it will emerge as a concentrated beam of light, strong enough to pierce the veil around Zeromus. We make our way to the first, and happily, Zero's able to travel with us. We reunite with our allies there, who are still working hard to restore their world to its former glory.
Restoring the elements to the empty may allow life to flourish there once more. But that isn't enough to return the environment to the way it was.
Oh, what a welcome surprise!
You wish to combat this otherworldly threat with the power of light? Please, let me help. Though I've lost my connection to Hydaelyn, I can still manipulate light to a degree.
We take some time to catch up with everybody else, and Zero is restored to her corporeal self thanks to Beg Luck.
Tis done. Zero is now with us in the flesh.
My thanks for your help.
You'll think nothing of it. That said, tis customary that my kind receive fitting payment for services rendered.
Not unlike we Void Sent, then. In that case, you may devour some of my ether.
Are you mad? I'll do no such thing. The very suggestion is absurd.
Given the nature of what we are about to do, we need to inform everybody first, as it will be quite literally a light show, and these actions may upset many. As such, we pay a visit to some old friends, to inform them of our plan, and they agree to spread the word far and wide of what the Warrior of Darkness is planning, and the mission to stop the darkness on the 13th, just how they once stopped the light. Spreading the word will take some time, so we aid the people of the first in any way we can. Once preparations are completed, we make our way to what remains of Nabat Arang and the Flood of Light. Once we arrive, we begin putting the plan into action.
So this is the Flood of Light. I don't remember much of the time when darkness consumed the 13th. Just the cold and the emptiness. Let's get started then, shall we?
The other transmitters are set. Whenever you're ready.
Thank you.
radiant light. It's almost too much for one steeped in darkness like me.
Whatever may have happened in the past, you're still here, Zero, alive. What you couldn't do yesterday, you might still do today.
If this power were mine to wield...
She's taken light into herself. Her body struggles to contain it. She needs help.
Better now, I think.
Then you're very, very lucky. Whatever possessed you to do that?
I had to know if I could command the light. If I could change my fate. Once, I would never have dared to dream it. But your friendship and your trust has helped me to see new possibilities in myself and everything else. Perhaps that's why, when I beheld this world once damned yet saved, I saw the potential for mine to be saved as well. To become a world where light and darkness are in harmony, and life flourishes. A world where we're not consumed by insatiable hunger, but filled with hope for what we might create together. If I had the strength, perhaps I could make such a dream reality. Perhaps I could awaken us from this endless nightmare. That's what possessed me.
If that's your heartfelt desire, then you mustn't be afraid to share it. There was a time when I lacked the courage. To voice my desires was to burden those I love, or so I convinced myself. Then I met those who believed in me. They helped me to believe in myself and find the strength to live. And so long as I'm alive, I know that I'll be fine. No matter how dire things seem, no matter where I am. To be able to think that brought me peace. And it's a blessing I owe entirely to my friends.
Those who believe in us. I will remember your words. I know all too well that there's a limit to what we can achieve alone.
As a friend,
I'd like to help you fulfill your dream. If you wish to take in more light, I can keep the power in check and help your body accept it.
Right then. I'm counting on you. Here I go. I can feel it. The light's warmth welling within me.
Then I believe it worked.
With this power, I will return to the void and fight for the world that once was, and for those I hold dear.
With our mission completed on the first, we proceed back to Radzatan to inform our allies. Ystola can see as to a blinding sun that Zero has been changed by absorbing the light. We don't have time to spare, however, as events are unfolding on the moon. The seals are giving way, and Zeromus is keen not to be denied entry to the source any longer. Together, we fly onto the void once more. Before us sits the crater, and within its unending darkness lies Zeromus.
All is in readiness. Without further ado, then. Light from beyond the rift, shine forth and banish the darkness.
Excellent. The tower is replete with light from the Ba'ath Areng.
Commencing transmission.
May this light illuminate your way.
You can do it, Zero. I believe in you.
Look, an opening.
It worked. Let us waste no time and sally forth.
The chasm swarms with void scent.
Summoned by Golbez, perhaps, or born of the residual darkness.
However they came to be, we shall cut a path through them. Is everyone ready?
Aye.
That light should shine in the void once more.
No single one of us could have made it so. Only by joining hands were we able to kindle this light.
Do you see, Golbez? We needn't damn others to save ourselves. You knew this once, surely, when you tried to befriend me. When you were one of the precious few left willing to trust in another. But that man is gone. And in his place, a mockery of his beliefs. It's the same as before. Though we walk different paths, we seek the same destination. And yet... there is something I must know. A truth that lies waiting in the dark.
With the Sword of Light granting us an entryway, we delve into the darkness of the lunar subterrain. The subterrain primarily consists of a facility that once held the fragment of Zodiark. Once it was vacated, Golbez turned it into his base of operations. As we venture through to find him, we encounter the memoria that was previously lost in the darkness when Zero was awakened. Whomever was sealed within had something they wished us to see.
Hurry, Golbez! The city is already overrun!
We take on the guise of Golbez, with his friend Durante fighting alongside us, as we try to keep the city of Baron from falling.
First the villages, and now the capital. Nothing is exempt from their avarice. And they command such terrible beasts bodes ill. We've no time to lose. Such destruction. If only we had returned sooner.
Fighting our way through memoriates and monsters, we reach the end of our path, where Golbez finds himself corrupted by a fallen memoriate, forcing Durante to embrace the darkness to slay him.
Golbez! This can't be happening. Not to you. My friend. My hero. I will stop you even should it cost me my life. So be it. I will fight you with all my strength. Ether, to fortify my blade. I need power. Light or dark, it matters not. Even so, I'll not be bested. Not this day. Prepare yourself. It's over, my friend. Why you and not me? You were the best of us. A paragon of virtue. I could never hope to be your equal. I am only the knight I am because of you. Because you believed in me! Wish to become a monster, preying upon those who fought to protect. But neither can I bring myself to kill you. You will never die. This I swear. Through me, your name shall live on as the hero who saves the world.
We've been released from the memory, 'twould seem.
If Golbez was the one sealed in this memoria, then the one we've been fighting is...
no more than an imposter.
playing at hero.
Our enemy stands before us, but things have changed. Our picture of the man, after seeing his friend's memory of him. In the end, it's Zero who puts the pieces together, and not only gets to the truth, but also to reason with Golbez.
History shall remember only Golbez. Come what may, I shall deliver the world its salvation, and I will not suffer you to interfere.
You seek to free all souls from the purgatory of undeath. And to that end, you would invade another world. While I cannot condone your methods, I understand your motive full well. For I'm driven by the same. I too wish to save our world. I too once thought I had to bear the burden by myself. That I had no choice but to walk my path alone. But I was wrong. We may yet strive together towards our shared goal. If you would reconsider your course.
If you possessed power which transcended that of Zeromus, then perhaps I would. But you do not. No, you are but another Voigtzent like me. And what is a candle before the sun?
Perhaps we aren't all powerful, and cannot effect great change in an instant. Even so.
Great change is what we need. Aught less has no meaning. Having glimpsed our past, you should understand as well as any. As Golbez, I dedicated myself to ending the Contra Memoria. I fought the corrupted Memoriates and attempted to redeem those twisted by their power. Yet try as I might, I was powerless to make any meaningful change. 'Twas then, when I was floundering in despair, that she appeared. The Ascian Igeom. Claiming to know how to excise the source of our woes, she showed me to the moon, where the servant of light abided. 'Twas he and his ilk who had granted men unnatural powers, she said, and now prolonged the war. Believing her every word, I struck him down and caused darkness to engulf the world.
What? Then it was you who...
Having left a ruin of our world, the Ascian fled. I was a fool to trust them, to trust in others. Since that day, I have sought the means to undo my mistake. The world may be beyond saving, but I would at least restore the great flow. For an eternity, I had to bide my time. But the day finally came when I acquired the power I sought. I, the remnants of the Ascian's god sealed within the moon suddenly dispersed into ether. With that ether, Zeromus could be conceived, and driven by the dragon's longing for home, it shall soon arise to destroy the barrier between worlds. Thus will the way open to the promised land, and the death we have been too long denied. Thus will I, Golbez, bring salvation to all!
So that is all you have left.
Say what you will. You cannot stop Zeromus's awakening. I had hoped to bear witness to the moment our salvation is realized. But nothing must be left to chance. I will stop you here, no matter the cost.
We'll tend to the Archfiends. Go and put an end to Zeromus.
You'll do no such thing.
We'll join you as soon as we can.
Zeromus has awoken, and will prove to be a powerful foe to overcome, especially here in the Void.
Space.
We are able to achieve victory in the battle, but the war will be lost due to the nature of what Wyrmus is.
Sent, Wyrmus cannot be killed. Sealing it in memoria is the only way.
Disperse Wyrmus' essence once more. The instant we do, you must call to Ashdaya.
Understood.
Dear friend, fell for the Ascian's ploy and unleashed the darkness. How disappointed must you be in me, in the foolishness and futility of it all? No, I will not let it be for naught. I will not allow you to pass. I will triumph in my crusade.
There is no triumph to be found in this madness. Even if the veil were to be unraveled, it would not undo what darkness has done to the world. Nor would it bring Golbez back. From his slumber, you know there is no return.
Light. But how?
This is proof that I believe in others, and they in turn believe in me. A light that illuminates the way in darkest despair. Be it in a ruined city locked in ice, or a world drowning in light, It was with faith in one another that life endured. I see it clearly now.
You think we are capable of the same?
It won't be easy. Having lived too long as Void Sent, we've forgotten how to trust. But one thing is certain. If Zeromus succeeds and everyone dies, we'll never have the chance to try. You asked me to join hands with you once, and I refused. I cannot take back that mistake. But I can extend to you the same offer. We can be better than we have been.
You were the Memoriate we met all those years ago.
You're Golbez now. If you would live up to his name, then you must trust in people as he did.
You truly believe the world of old can be ours again?
I do. So long as we work together.
Be strong, Zero. Don't give up. Hold fast to yourself. Look to the light within.
Your place isn't alone in the dark, Zero. Not anymore.
Of course. With this power from beyond the rift, I can do it. I can save everyone. Golbez, if you would make amends, then lend me your strength.
Hear my voice and return to me!
Romus makes to resurrect.
Not if I have anything to say about it. No more, fiend!
You're safe now, Ashdaya. You're safe. To my sister, I shall offer up the eye in this vessel. We dragons bring forth progeny with our very life force. That which my eye harbors should be enough to grant her corporeal form. Of course, this means I shall no longer have control over this vessel. I must ask you escort Ashdaya to the surface in my stead.
We came to bring her home, and we'll do just that. You have my word.
Thank you. At long last, we shall be together again.
Where are you going?
Our world may yet be restored. I thought it an impossible dream once, but having witnessed your miracles, I cannot help but believe. Nevertheless, I am the villain who wrought this tragedy. And in my misguided crusade, I compounded my sins.
Regardless of how you may feel, by lending me your strength, you've made amends. You've earned a new beginning. What we couldn't do yesterday, we might still do today. Working together. So let's take the first step. The two of us.
our mission on the 13th is finally complete. Or rather, the original mission, finding Ashdaya and stopping Golbez. The restoration of the 13th will be what comes next. And for that plan to begin, our new dear friend must remain behind.
Together with Golbez, I hope to do the same as we labor to restore the 13th.
Then I suppose it's farewell for now.
Be sure to share with Golbez what you've learned of the Source and its reflections, as well as the true nature of light and dark.
Indeed. Once we've gained a better understanding of the situation, I hope we can rely on your counsel.
Nidana provided me with spare warding scales, which apparently provide greater protection than before. This should keep the familiar safe. So long as you give the Nixie Aether from time to time, it will persist and serve as a beacon for us to find you.
When you have the chance, please thank everyone for me. Those in Razatan, Garlemald, Charlien. The First and on the Moon. A lengthy list. A gift for Rhin, in return for the light she helped me harness. It's the Memoria holding Xeromus. If used to augment darkness in the First, it may help to create balance between our worlds.
Sad though it is to say farewell, it is past time we returned home. Pray, climb upon my back.
Till we meet again.
We make our way back to the Source, bringing Ashdaya with us. We travel around and inform our friends and allies of what transpired on the 13th.
Oh, it's you again. Is everything all right? So you were able to rescue Ashdaya. Thank the 12.
Channeling light from the First was rather ingenious. It may fall short of cross-rift travel, but it's still an impressive achievement in my book.
Zero stayed in the void, did she? Well, if I had known it would come to that, I would have said a proper farewell. Really? I don't remember saying anything profound. Still, I'm glad that she got something out of her time here. As the days roll on, things will change for the both of us. But some things will remain as they are. As far as I'm concerned, Zero will always be a friend and comrade. And I will never forget her.
If she's working tirelessly to restore the 13th, it wouldn't do to be outdone here. When next Zero visits, we must see to it that you have a shiny new Garlemald to show her.
On that note as well, the twins will be taking a break from their tireless efforts in Garlemald, at the behest of their friends there, for they have already done so much for them and the rest of their people. They return home to Charlien soon after, and we go along with them, after saying our goodbyes to Vitra and Ashdaya. The book has finally closed on our newfound adventure, and they who would beckon us to a new one are now stepping off the boat from the new worlds. For a dawn trail is awaiting us.